following is a presentation of TFNN. The Tom O'Brien Show is produced every business day. Tom takes your phone calls toll-free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044.
Let's go to our man Jim in Palm Harbor. Hey, what's going on, brother?
Hey, how you guys doing today?
Doing great, man. How you been?
Oh, great. I really appreciate you and Tommy. You do great job, great work, and I really appreciate it. I watch you every day.
Well, thank you so much. We appreciate you growling and prowling with us out here, man. Let's go to Sylvia in Tampa. Hey, Sylvia, how you doing?
Hey, Tom. Good morning. Thank you so much for taking my call. I want to tell you thank you so much for the advice you gave me on dust yesterday. I exited when you told me, and I made a healthy profit for
that's awesome.
For a very short period. So thank you.
Now, Tom O'Brien.
Welcome, folks. This is Tom O'Brien of TFNN. We go 5 days a week. We go 10 hours a day. We go 24 hours a day on the internet at TFNN.com. Always remember, folks, whatever you think about, you bring about. Whatever you focus on grows. Hope everyone's having a great day, safe day. Let's make it a great night, folks. Be impeccable with your word. Express your love. Impeccability of the word can be measured by a level of self-love. If you love yourself, you'll express that love in your interactions with others, and that action will produce a like reaction. Market-wise, let's take a look at it out here. We have the Dow Industrials up 267, NASDAQ up 83, S&P's up 23, gold contract up $3.20, trading at $12,1150 an ounce. Silver, trading up. Where are you, baby? Trading up 3 cents, $14.31 an ounce. Light sweet crude, down 32 cents, $70.80 a barrel. Notes, 10-year note up 2 ticks, 118.20, 30-year bond flatten out, 141.02. King dollar down 639 ticks, trading at 94.480. The euro is trading at 117.77 to one U.S. dollar. The yen is at 112.46 to one U.S. dollar. Our phone number is 877-927-6648. Give us a call, folks. Want to know what's going on in your world. In the world of the S&Ps, let's take a look at them. What do you have? We go over to the SPY. What you're going to see, the SPY's at an all-time high. You have done the 62 million shares. You're up $2.45. Your last high out here had 61 million, so the SPY's going to be doing some volume. Bottom line, it's been up here for a while. It has the juice behind the move. Dow Industrials took 8 months to get up to the high, but guess what? You got to the high, you took out the high, all of the above, and the high that we're talking in the Dow Industrials, 26,616, you're at 26,667. Percentage-wise out here, what the indices are doing is that you have the NASDAQ up 1%, Dow's up 1%, S&Ps are up 0.8%. Gold contract, we go take a look at the gold contract out here. Gold contract, bottom line, needs spread, price spread. The volume, we need volume too. What we have the divergence out here, and we've had it for quite some time, is that we have gold up $3.10. You've done 224,000 contracts. You're going to need a good 300,000. We'll do like 250 today. That being said, the sellers are laying at 1218 to 1220. Where the divergence comes out here is that even with the dollar index getting smoked today, gold cannot catch a bid. You know, doesn't mean it won't as the dollar continues lower. But this is the type of divergence that we have had, and we have had since going all the way back to April 4th. If we go take a look at this dollar index, what you're going to see with the index is that you've been moving down. You have the volume behind the move, you know, and you can see if you happen to be watching Tiger TV right now, you can see that the sellers that came out here this morning, bottom line, is still right here. We have the volume expanding in the last 15, 20 minutes. So what I expect we're going to see is that we're going to be down into this low. Right now, we're down 639 ticks. We were as low as this morning is down, we're down almost 750 ticks. It looks to me like that's where this thing wants to shake out. Now, what we also have is that you broke a swing point, The swing point that we broke, let me go back on the other contract. I got to look at the other contract for a second. So let's see. We're 27,000 contracts. If we back down into the U contract, we take a look at the U contract, and we turn around and put that swing point up. That swing point, yeah, we're breaking it with volume. That swing point at 18,000 contracts. So bottom line is that you're doing it with volume. In fact, if we go take a look at the UUP, which is one of the ETF structures for the index, you can match that volume out there, and you're going to see the swing point there had 994,000. You've already broken it with 1 million. What you're doing is that you are going into the big strength. Now, the big strength had 3.8 million, so you're not going to break that down ASAP. The way that the dollar is trading, however, is that that's saying that it does want to get in to the strength where the dollar went up 2 pennies on the 14th of June. That's when we went from the 94,500 up to that 96,600. So bottom line is that you're moving down with conviction. Some of the higher volume equities, well, hey, actually, let's go over to the euro. We'll take a look at the euro and see if, in fact, the euro stopped moving topside last night. Yeah, the euro. Okay, so the euro is up 105 ticks. You're at 117.78. Now, this is going into the same June 14th number. If the euro can launch, this is where this is going to get interesting, folks, because if the euro can launch the 118 level, yeah, it's 118.51. There's not much in the way that euro can be up to 122. You know, it's kind of a beautiful little setup, actually. And if you aren't a head and shoulders, we just may have a head and shoulders in place here. And if that's the case, you got 113. You get four. Yeah, if that's in place, that's saying that the euro can go to 121. And the top of the last range up there was the 125, it actually was. The top of the range is 125. The bottom of the range was 122. We'll get over and let's go take a look at the British pound, too, then, since we get these things moving. Okay, so where are you, pound? There we go. Okay, so we have the pound trading. I see, interesting. So the pound's up 127 ticks. You're off the low of 126. You're at 132. This is a similar setup. So it's going to be all about the dollar. That's the real bottom line. That's how this whole thing is shaken out. But it looks also that this is moving with strength. The pound looks like it wants to run to this 133.63 number. And if you do get volume behind that move, bottom line is that you can get a lot higher because there's not much in the way. Dow Industrials right now up 282. You got the NASDAQ up 88. S&P's up 24. Stay right there, folks. Good on, man. Mr. Jason Path coming up. Growling a problem with us. Be right back.
Folks, Tom O'Brien here. If you'd like to get my daily newsletter, Market Insights, then now is a great time to sign up for a 30-day free trial. Every morning by 9:30, I send out my morning letter to subscribers with market commentary on a variety of markets, currencies, and commodities to keep investors up to date on the day's trading action. Included in Market Insights are specific buy and sell recommendations for stocks, ETFs, and even options, with stops and price targets included for every trade in my newsletter. If you'd like to try my newsletter risk-free for 30 days, then head over to the front page of TFNN and you'll find Market Insights under Trading Newsletters. I use my years of trading experience to bisect and dissect the market every morning and give my subscribers the most important information they need to know for the day ahead. I even issue afternoon updates for my subscribers whenever warranted with important market action. I'm always scouring the market for the next great trading opportunity. Sign up for your 30-day free trial to my daily newsletter, Market Insights, today by visiting the front page of TFNN.com. Wow! Go get them, folks.
In quiet markets, investors search for new trading opportunities. We'd like to introduce you to a new product that provides opportunities even in flat markets. Nadex, the North American Derivatives Exchange, is a new and innovative Chicago-based exchange registered with the Commodity Futures Trading Commission. And unlike most other exchanges, Nadex allows you to trade directly through them with direct market access when using their trading platform. Nadex never charges a fee to use their platform, which even includes real-time charts and full customization capability. Nadex's unique short-term binary options allow traders and investors to capitalize on strategies even when the underlying markets are quiet. Nadex's innovation has allowed them to come up with a line of unique trading products that are unavailable anywhere else. See how it works at Nadex.com. That's Nadex.com, or click on the Nadex banner on the front page of TFNN.com. Futures and options trading involves risk and may not be appropriate for all investors. Until recently, it was almost impossible for the average investor to hedge against currency risk in Europe or Japan. For a bold trade on Europe or Japan that protects against moves in currency, trade HEGE or HEGJ, two times currency hedged leveraged ETFs from Direction Investments. Visit directioninvestments.com today. An investor should consider the investment objectives, risks, charges, and expenses of the Direction shares carefully before investing. The prospectus and summary prospectus contain this and other information about Direction shares. To obtain a prospectus or summary prospectus, please contact Direction shares at 866-476-7523. The prospectus or summary prospectus should be read carefully before investing. An investment in the funds is subject to risk, including the possible loss of principal. The funds are designed to be utilized only by sophisticated investors such as traders and active investors. Distributor Foreside Fund Services, LLC.
Call now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-873-7618.
Welcome back, folks. Dow Industrial is up 289, NASDAQ up 87, S&P's up 25. Let's go to our man, Mr. Jason Path, as we do each and every Thursday at 20 past the first hour. And don't forget, folks, Jason kicks us off every trading day right here at TFNN, 8:30 in the morning, 8:30 to 9, morning market kickoff. He also has a great newsletter, and you're going to be able to get that newsletter right at TFNN, folks, Monday morning. And, you know, inside that newsletter, you get a lot of action. He talks Bitcoin. Bottom line is that, you know, we had the crypto craze going on, and now it's the reefer madness craze, and there's no doubt that good old Tilray, I mean, the jokes are just going to nonstop because it definitely has gone up in smoke in one day. It went from $300. We had a low today of 158. We're trading 173, and this is just don't touch the stock. That's the bottom line, folks. Jason, what's going on, brother?
Hey, not much, man.
Whoa, I'm telling
you. Those in nice, Tom. I like that. Don't touch the stuff, man. Don't touch the stock.
Yeah. this equity, folks. Okay, so picture this: the equity itself. I mean, we have seen this happen before. Okay, we haven't seen it. You know, really, something like this since like 1999. And there was a lot more stocks in 1999 that did something like this. But I'll tell you something, man. If you want to trade these, well, if you want to trade Tilray, don't trade it and go trade MJ. Because MJ, folks, is the, you know, the ETF structure that this has the 10%, 9.9. Now, okay, so this is a weighted equity. So now MJ has 14% weighting structure inside it. Cronus has a 10% weighting structure. Canopy has a 9. Aurora has an 8. So if you have to trade Tilray, go trade it in this equity because you won't get hurt as bad and you won't make as much or lose as much. But guess what? You want to be alive at the end of the day. I'm telling you, man. That stock yesterday, well, even today, Jason, it was pretty amazing, man. You know?
Yeah, I mean, I was trying to remember. I don't know that I've seen something like yesterday happened with a single issue. You know, you'll have, you know, a crazy story across the wire and the halt trading, but the start and the stop and the on and the off and the
yes.
width of the moves.
No, I agree.
I've never seen anything like that.
Yeah, and I'm not sure whether, I remember And in 2000, I definitely remember JDSU, because I was one of the biggest ABCs up that we ever got. It was a 225-point ABC up. That it went from 200 to 800, and then it crashed from 800 to like 450 in a week. It was like, but in a day, yeah, I there's no doubt, man. It's like, and it's almost like it's hard to comprehend. What I'm trying to figure out is like, is the greed so tremendous, and we're at such a point in the marketplace that day traders are actually buying 100 shares at $250, and you blink and it's 300, and you blink it's 150. And if that's the case, man, God bless them.
Yeah, I mean, we've democratized access to the markets to anybody with a modem and some money. And, you know, it's kind of these lifestyle type offerings, too, that get that extra wave of fervor. That's what you saw with crypto. You know, for some people, it was a statement, right? And you see that with the weed play. Yeah, I think yesterday was, in my opinion, it's really hard to unpack the numbers, but there was definitely a short squeeze. You know, after we went on Cramer and built a little momentum in the morning, you had some, you know, you had a bit of a short squeeze. It still got tremendous short interest, even with the expense of that type of play. I just think that it got meteoric off the short squeeze. You got some momentum off the Cramer deal.
Right.
It's really hard to know. I mean, after like 11 a.m., I really don't know what was happening with the issue, except it just kept going up, getting halted, coming back down, going up. But it was a wild ride, man.
And I'd suggest
$40 now.
Yeah, and I'd suggest, folks, if you're going to trade it, right, get over to the NASDAQ and find out exactly what the rules are for the circuit breakers. Because what happens is that if you've never seen how a circuit breaker works, I mean, if you know, you want to know, because you don't want to be in front of the screen, whether you're long or short. And, you know, there's certain rules, and you want to know them upside down. And I don't know the exact rules inside the NASDAQ, because, you know, they have certain ones in the NYSE, they have certain ones in the future markets, okay? And they're spelled out really clearly, too. So just make sure you do that, because it's... You know, and I suspect it's not over yet. You know what I mean? It's like,
oh yeah,
yeah.
I mean, it's still at you know, $100 some odd, $170. So it's still got a ways to go, man. Where does this thing open tomorrow? I mean, I couldn't even begin to guess.
Exactly. And you know, if we take a look, and if you want to see, you know, it's amazing, folks. And if you want to see just how cool the option market actually is, Tommy and I had brought this back. Up last week, Jason, and it was like, you know, when I first started moving, I said, man, this is amazing, you know, and I was basically saying, it's hard to comprehend that the option market makers were putting a 50% premium into the options, and they were right. That's the thing that's amazing to me. Do you know, you had to have a 50% premium into it, you know? Like, so right now, oh, look at this, so right now, it's actually more than a 50%. I'm bringing up the same one. I'm bringing up the December calls and puts. And now the puts have more than a 50% premium in them, folks. It costs you $91 to buy an in-the-money 175 put for December. How's that? Wow.
Yeah, I mean, what's interesting to me, too, is, you know, is there a better weed play than Tilray? It's Tilray, right? Like, the whole sector is definitely up, no question.
Yes.
But this ride with Tilray, and obviously part of it is the float, and how, you know, the size of the float, but it's just, you know, the whole sector has been certainly up, but the Tilray aspect of it, and you know,
no, I agree. And what I think I always thought that Canopy was the best play, because Canopy,
right,
they're large, they're already pulling a lot of bread. I get a feeling what the market looked at when they are the first ones from Canada to get the okay from the Drug Enforcement Administration. It's like, okay, man, politically, they must be hooked in. Yeah, that's, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
And then when you saw that Peter Thiel is one of the largest owners of Privateer, it's like, okay, man, because we know pot's a political deal right now. I mean, you need the licensing, you need the bread behind you, you need the connections, you need the Rolodex, okay? This, you know, you're not going to walk in and just get a license. And I suspect that, you know, my take would be Canopy is still the deal, but, you know.
Right. Yeah, I mean, I was watching the guy on, Kramer, and no disrespect, but, I was, I just didn't see the leader of a multi-billion dollar, budding conglomerate there, right? Like, it was kind of a, it was an interesting interview, and, he's a smart guy, and clearly, he's having some success now. But to your point on Canopy or some other, with some infrastructure and, the Tilray thing is fascinating to me.
It is.
Again, they got the first license, to your point. There's definitely some reasons, but if I'm really playing, because folks will talk about, long-term addressable market. Again, I just don't see Tilray. There's going to be a lot of competition. It's going to be a lot of competition, and first normally isn't there at the end, just because you're first.
Well, that's why they call it weed, right? It grows like a weed. I had to start Tilray off with you, because I just knew, between the cryptos, that's the closest thing to crypto, right?
The same time of year last year that Bitcoin took off.
Is it? Oh, my God. Right there. Jason and I come right back.
No matter what kind of trader you are, 2018 is a great time to try out a subscription to Tom O'Brien's Gold Report. Whether you just plan on diversifying your portfolio with some exposure to gold and gold mining equities, or you're a gold bull that sees 2018 as the year of commodities, now is a great time to sign up for the Gold Report. Tom O'Brien publishes his Gold Report every Monday morning before the market opens and covers a variety of topics, including gold, silver, platinum, copper, the XAU and HUI, the dollar, bonds, South African rand, as well as more than 20 of the most actively traded mining equities. Start your 2018 off with a bang and sign up for the Gold Report today. The Gold Report is a long-term newsletter where the focus is on building real wealth through the management of a successful portfolio of gold stocks. For all the details and to start your subscription right now, visit the front page of TFNN.com and you'll find the Gold Report under Investment Newsletters.
Hi folks, this is Tom O'Brien. If you'd like to be the bank and get the type of interest they receive instead of the low interest rates they give to clients, then I have an investment you may want to take a look at. I'm offering 4-year secured first mortgages on buildable city lots in St. Petersburg, Florida. The investment can be anywhere from $30,000 to $75,000 per buildable city lot. The interest paid is 7% per year, paid monthly. Depending on the investment, the income per month per lot ranged from $175 for a $30,000 investment to $437.50 for a $75,000 investment. If you are in the CD market, you want to look at this investment. St. Petersburg is located in Pinellas County, which is the densest county in Florida. If you're looking for an investment with your principal intact that pays a good interest rate, this may be for you. The supply is limited, so act now. For more information on these secured first mortgage opportunities, you can call me at 877-518-9190. That's 877-518-9190.
David White's newsletter, The Technology Insider, is focused like a laser on finding the next big things in technology. If you had invested only $10,000 in Microsoft in 1986, you'd have been a millionaire by 2000. Disruptive technology like Microsoft's is the key to these massive long-term profits, and The Tech Insider is the vehicle from TFNN to capitalize on these opportunities. This is the go-to newsletter that identifies, monitors, and profits on mostly little-known cutting-edge companies with great long-term prospects. David's experience is as an inventor of Emmy-winning animation products for TV and Hollywood that propelled a company public. Match that with 14 years as a full-time trader, and he's uniquely qualified to guide you through the light-speed world of ever-evolving high-tech. If you're ready to ride the next big technology bull market for less than $40 per month, log on to TFNN.com and get your 2-week free trial to the Technology Insider. Get in on the ground floor of the next big thing today.
This segment is brought to you by Think or Swim. For more information, just click the Think or Swim banner on the front page of TFNN.com.
Back, folks. Jason Path, Tom O'Brien, we appreciate you growling and prowling with us. Don't forget, folks, Jason kicks us off every trading day right here at TFNN, 8:30 in the morning. And, Jason, we're talking Tilray, and look, this is sad. So this came across the tape just as we're talking about this. I don't know this firm. It might be a small firm. But anyway, Charles Finney left his job at Roth Capital Partners just days after analysts downgraded the high-flying pot stock Tilray. Finney left on his own accord. He probably just got discouraged. I'm sure he's right. I mean, give me a break.
That's the thing.
Yeah.
I mean, he's long-term probably right. But, I'm there. I get it, man. I mean, right. It's a, you know, to you just, I mean, you see stuff now that it just blows your mind. And yeah, you just kind of, when the old rules don't apply and all you know is the new rules or the old rules, then
yep.
You probably just get frustrated, man.
Listen, I remember, you know what this reminds me of, folks? Okay, the Tilray, but this is, you just brought up something that I'll tell the story. This is, anyone around that was day trading it in the 90s would know something like this, but we were I was beside a guy, and what he would do every single night, right? He would just buy like every tech stock, like, and then he'd come in the morning, right? And I'd look at him saying, I can't believe this, man. The guy's up like $60,000-$70,000. And I'd be closing my positions out. I couldn't stand going overnight, right? Because when we were day trading, we were doing hundreds of trades a day. And I'm looking, I'm saying to myself, man, there's something wrong with me, you know?
Right.
And it is what it is, you know what I mean? But I couldn't do it. He could do it. I don't know how it ended up. I don't, you know what I mean? But it's almost just like that. Like you said at the beginning, what's going to open tomorrow morning? Do you know what I mean?
No. Yeah, I mean, I started talking, you know, this morning we were talking about it a little bit, and I started talking about, you know, market caps, and I was like, this stuff doesn't even matter anymore, you know, after I was talking about it even, I'm like, you know, who cares what you know, because I was talking about the market cap in relation to the addressable market. I mean, the market caps of companies are larger than the potential revenue at this point.
Well, listen to this. This is pretty
but it
cool.
It doesn't matter.
No, it doesn't matter. When I was looking at Tilray yesterday, right? So here, we can still do it today. This is to me, this is a total mind blower. Because this is one of your favorite stocks, too. I'm bringing up your favorite stock. I think you shot the stock. You shot Barrick, right?
But well, no, not sure Barrick. Oh. I had a target into short it. We're getting closer to it.
Oh, okay.
A little north of it. Yeah, we were looking at Barrick.
So listen to this,
not
folks.
Sure yet.
So this gets sick. So Tilray has a market cap of $16.1 billion. That's at down $40 at $173, right? Barrick Gold, which is the largest gold company in the world, has a market cap of $12.3 billion. But this is the bizarre part. When you take a look at the earnings, that Barrick Gold basically brings home $540 million a year in earnings, okay? Where Tilray only takes in $41 million in revenue. It's like, okay, how's that?
Yeah. I mean, exactly. You know, it
doesn't
matter anymore, man.
It doesn't.
At least in shorter time slices, right? It just...
Right. And you know what, like, you know, which we all know, and bringing it up in the den, there's no doubt. You know, like Dave's saying, well, listen, a lot of states you can grow 10 plants. Now, we can't do that in Florida, but I guess there's a lot of states you can grow 3 to 10 plants. You can grow plants. That's the bottom line. Then what you have is that, you know, a few of these claiming that, okay, they got better science and all that. It was like, okay, give me a break. You're not going to have better science. It's the extraction of the THC or the CBD. And guess what? You know, you get, once you're into a couple million bucks, there's no reason you can't, they all
there's
can't
no
be
moat.
The same, right? Yeah, right.
Yeah, there's no long-term moat.
Right, right. It's not like you have the Coca-Cola formula and no one else can have it, right?
Right.
Yeah,
that's right.
Pretty wild. Okay, so hey, let's. I get your newsletter up here.
Yeah.
Where'd you like to start?
Boy, you know, interesting market in rates. You know, we've been following bonds pretty closely lately, you know, we're tracking high yield more longer term. But you know, something else that's just kind of broke down lately, right? Is, you know, the rapid rise in rates, and you know, equities just don't care. We've even seen EM cool off with a spike in the 10-year here. So, you know, it's kind of toward the theme of our conversation here, some of the old stuff doesn't apply. I mean, at some point, the market will care. I heard you talking earlier, though, you know, the dollar's down, gold is up, but not up relative
can't catch
to the
a bid.
Move in the dollar.
I know.
Right. You know, the rates have really risen rapidly. Equities have shrugged it off. EM's quiet. So some of those old relationships, have certainly broken down. And, you know, here we are at record highs. We've got a trade war. We got higher rates. We're going into 2 rate hikes towards the end of the year. We got, you know, unresolved issues with Great Britain and Europe. And, you know, we're at record highs. And, you know, Europe was up last night and probably be up again tonight. So it's in the short term here, this is a very interesting week to me. It's been quiet from a data perspective for the most part.
Well, I hope you emptied all your bank account out and your kids' bank account, put it all in the market today, right? Yeah. I'm only kidding, folks. I'm only kidding. Seriously,
right.
Seriously. You know, so hey, let's stay with rates for a second because, you know, there's no doubt this is a major break, folks, when it broke the August swing. Right. But it's going to get intriguing here because, you know, there's not, you know, the 10-year's only done 1.5 million contracts today. That's not a lot of contracts, you know, to be at lows or at highs. So I guess we'll see where that shakes out. But we're definitely approaching the, we hit 306. 311 is the number for the high for the year. But it is amazing how the market itself has just shaken everything off. You know, no doubt. Hey,
yeah, just
let's go into natural gas, man.
Yeah, no, that's a fun market this week. We liked it higher this week, and you know, it continues to work its way higher. We had a, it was pretty in line with expectations on inventories today, maybe a little bit past that. But you know, we need to start seeing some three-digit injections into storage, you know, and today in the mid-80s wasn't quite there. Again, you know, a bit of a familiar refrain from me at this point, but, you know, we're historically low on inventories at this point in the season. You know, fair value would be right now, you know, 320 to 330. The challenge is we're also at historic levels of production. So the variable becomes the weather, you know, and again, as we've seen a little tilt in the weather this week to hotter next week, but then on the longer term models, cooler sooner in October.
Really? Okay.
Not a massive shift, but you know, cooler in October, a few more heating degree days here at the end of September. So, you know, I'm very bullish on gas at this point. I think it continues to work its way higher.
Yeah. Quite a good bid out here, man. I mean, it had a huge bid on, Tuesday.
Yeah, what you saw really back to Monday and Tuesday was the spot market really go nuts, and it kind of led futures. That doesn't always happen, but it happened earlier this week. Folks were able to, you know, in the spot market, you know, with gas at $3 and the futures lower, you could sell gas and then, you know, just replenish it later with cheaper gas until it, you know, caught up.
So how cool is that, huh?
We expected to see that. Yeah, that's what we said. That was literally the dynamic Monday.
Wow.
If you remember, the move was really quick up because, you know, you were at three.
Yeah.
You got to 290, once you hit 297 at Henry Hub, you saw that dynamic shift and the futures took off because, again, you were just able to you know, sell
lock
it for $3,
right?
Replenish
like
it with cheaper gas right off the top. So that gave us a quicker move at the beginning of the week, and it rallied a little bit more, got another leg up on the, again, a little cooler in October, a little warmer next week. Weather gives it a little nudge higher today.
Gotta love it. Listen, man, thanks so much. Look forward to the show tomorrow.
Thank you, man.
Thanks, Jason.
Can't wait.
Stay right there, folks.
No,
come right back.
Many of our new listeners have heard about The Tiger's Den. The Tiger's Den is a lively community where professional traders and investors can meet, exchange ideas and information in a comfortable, moderated atmosphere. Hear all of the TFNN shows, plus see all of the charts as they happen live and have access to archives of all of those charts. You can test drive The Tiger's Den absolutely free for 30 days and greatly enrich your knowledge of these markets and how to make your money work for you. Details on The Tiger's Den are on the front page of TFNN.com.
Monday, September 24th, TFNN is launching a new updated version of our website. You can still visit us at the same TFNN.com URL, and starting Monday, you'll be able to experience the new and improved TFNN website. If you're a current subscriber, don't worry, your subscription will be automatically transferred. The new TFNN.com will allow much easier access to all your account and subscription information. Get ready for the new TFNN.com, educating investors.
I'm certain you are or strive to be one of the best of the best at everything you do in life. It's the most common trait that we tigers and tigresses share. If you're looking to become the best of the best when it comes to managing your money, let me teach you to do what most wealth managers tell you can't be done, which is how to time the markets. I'm Steve Rhodes, author of Mastering Probability, and for the last 12 months, Timer Digest has been tracking my newsletter signals, which have earned me the ranking as their number one market timer in the nation for the S&P 500 for the last 12, 6, and 3 months. Timer Digest also ranks me as the number one market timer for gold as well. The fact is, markets can be timed, and I'll teach you the exact set of tools that I use that has transformed me into one of the best at what I do. Sign up for Mastering Probability today by clicking on the newsletter tab on the homepage of TFNN.com and get immediate access to workshops where I take you step by step how to use an extraordinary set of tools as well as provide great market calls too. Sign up today.
The Path of Least Resistance, David White's daily market letter, gives you trade recommendations based on David's proprietary power law vector indicator that put the odds of success overwhelmingly in your favor. He'll give you the entry price, price target, and stop price for each stock and option trade. David combines his years of trading experience along with his background in technology and computing to offer his subscribers his take on the markets on a daily basis. Every trading day by 9:30, David publishes his morning issue of The Path of Least Resistance, along with updates sent out throughout the week whenever there is new actionable trading information. All new subscribers receive a 30-day, no-questions-asked, money-back guarantee. To sign up for David White's daily trading newsletter right now, visit the front page of TFNN.com and you'll find The Path of Least Resistance under Trading Newsletters.
Call now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-873-7618.
Tom O'Brien.
Welcome back, folks. Dow up 264, Nasdaq up 82, S&P's up 23. Let's go to Victor in Paramus, New Jersey. Hey, Victor, what's going on, brother?
Not much. After I talk to you, I just want your read on Apple. What do you think? But tomorrow is reading on Zero Hedge is quadruple expirations, and Google, Facebook, and all of that, and two other ones, AT&T and Intel, are coming out of the communication services. Like, they're reshuffling the S&P 500, and they're saying there's going to be a 25% correction in technology. You believe that or no?
In one day?
Not in one day, but they're saying by taking Facebook out and Google out of the S&P, you know, when they reshuffle and rebalance it, it's coming out of the communication
interesting
section.
Interesting.
Well, Goldman Sachs is actually saying that.
So they're saying that's coming out of the communication ETF
section.
Sector?
Yeah, the section. However you do the S&P 500, there's different sections in it, I guess.
Yeah, that's right. Okay.
Yeah, they're coming out tomorrow, supposedly, and so is AT&T and Intel.
And where are they putting them? They're putting them in another sector, though, right?
In another section. Yeah, yeah, that's what I'm saying.
Yeah, I'm going to have to look at that.
Go look at it on Zero Hedge. It's a Goldman Sachs article, so I don't know.
Well, what does happen is just that one of the tigers just gave me a heads up, too. What you do have, folks, is that the SPY has a dividend coming out tomorrow. The S&P has a dividend coming out tomorrow, too. Yeah.
Oh, so this could be a little. Maybe it's a little. It might get a little.
Well, that
what
will end up happening is that it'll pay the dividend and it will open up lower. That's how how it works. Yeah.
Where do you think Apple's going? I've been like buying it at 215 all the time and just selling it like at 220. I don't know. It seems kind of loose.
Well, you know, what is intriguing inside the NDX 100 as well as the Nasdaq is that you know. We are at all-time highs, and Google's at 1188, and the high is 1273. So that certainly can't get traction. And Facebook is not getting any traction either. You know, Facebook is way off its highs. I mean, Facebook, you know, you're down from 218, you're at 166. So that's saying quite a bit, I mean, in general. Do you know what I'm saying?
So tomorrow could be the beginning of a little correction then.
Hey. As you know? Jason and I were just talking, and he told me and I this morning, this market's shaking everything off. So
this reminds me of 2009. I guess Trump put the orders out. No, you listen to him.
The thing that's pretty wild here right now is this, and this is where, you know, we had the short-term rates going higher.
Yeah,
the 30-year bond,
today.
You know,
the 10-year went up.
Well, yeah, the 30-year bond is kind of just sitting here all day. We'll see if the market even pays attention to that. You know, thus far, the market hasn't. You know, my take still is that bonds do want to go lower. I mean, it looks to me that they broke, you know, the August low, and, you know, they basically didn't break them with volume. So it's like, okay, you want to go, it wasn't like you were going to go to the May low. But that being said, it's like, okay, the May low is not the end of the world. Like, if we look at the TLT, which is a 20-year plus ETF for the bonds, you know, we hit yesterday We got down at 116.19. The low is 116.09. Today, you basically, you know, come up slightly 51 cents. But it's like, okay, man, is that all the notes and bonds wanted to do? You know, what has happened is that as we've come up to the Fed meetings, it seems that, and this is about as, deviant as it can get, every time that the Fed raises their short-term rate bank to bank, that's when the bonds start rallying again. And so, you know, we have the meeting, and the meeting is next week, the 26th. And right now, if you're watching this, you can see there's 100% chance in the probability market that they're going to go up on rates. You know, now
would
in December,
where would you buy Apple at, though?
Apple? I wouldn't. If I was looking at Apple, I'd be. My take is that Apple's going to go down and test this 192 or 220.
It will. Yeah, close that gap.
Yeah.
You think so? Maybe MU will be the start tomorrow, Micron.
Well, yeah. Is that? I think that's tonight. Is it tonight? Let me see.
Yeah, tonight. That's what I mean. In a few hours.
Yeah, okay. Yeah. So yeah, that's good. Now there'll be some action here, folks, because Micron has already gone from price point of 64 to 46. Well, actually 44,
yeah.
I think. Yeah, to 40. And Micron. So this is. Oh, Victor, I'm so glad you called, man, because Micron. So check this out, folks. Micron just missed the February 9th swing low, which is $37.52. We got down to 40.68, and that has volume. So the way that Micron set up to go after this, after the close today. This is going to be interesting watching this shake out, man.
I'm going to have to wait and buy the text when nobody wants them again.
That's right. You're going to hear someone crying, and you're not going to hear anyone crying for a while. That's what it looks like.
All right. Have a good day.
You too, man. Have a great one. Have a safe one. Let's go take a look at some of the higher volume equities in this market out here, folks. You get Ford Motor is up 4 cents. We got, Apple's up 220. You got Microsoft up $2. Microsoft, interesting, man. They were selling Microsoft off yesterday. Look at this. And that's unusual. You really just don't see that fly. They sold it down $2 yesterday. Yeah, this brought it up today. Okay, that's what you got. Let's go over to the banks. The banks yesterday had a big day because the spread was getting bigger. Yeah, they're up today. The XLF's up today. You're at 28.97. And this is going to, go after this $29 level. The high is 30.32. No reason to kind of get there. But now this is weak. There's no doubt the banks are still weak compared to the aspect as to where the market itself is and has been. You got the Wells Fargo. What's going to be interesting about Wells Fargo, folks, they get a rumor floating out there that the Gary Cohen, got a call. That was what the rumor is anyway. He's not saying anything. That got a call about being the CEO of Wells Fargo. And Wells Fargo definitely needs some help. Real question is that does he want to step in the middle of that minefield? When I say help, they certainly don't need help making money. They make money hand over fist. But they need help because they have so many fines that are out there, frauds that are out there, all of the above. So it's almost a cult. It is a culture that basically it's built in. Yeah, when you're talking about bringing in the bread, though, they take in $86 billion. Imagine $86 billion you're taking in. They bring to the bottom line $4.41 each year. Growth-wise, no, they're not growing. They might be about, they're probably as big as they can get right now. It's one of those deals too big to fail, but then that's how that's kind of setting up. We go and take a look at the GDX. The GDX did get volume in it yesterday at the close. And what you have out here today, we get some nice volume out here today also. You get 27 million. Yesterday we did 50. That's going to do less volume today, but it put the juice into it. The next step for the GDX is going to be this $19.48. Right now you're at 18.92. Dow Industrials up 254, Nasdaq up 78, S&P's up 21. Come right back.
Larry Pesavento has just started his brand new service, Fibonacci 24/7, and he's already delivering content to his subscribers on a daily basis when the market's opened and even on weekends. Each Monday, you'll receive Larry's written report that provides detailed commentary and a summary on the charts and videos that Larry sends out. And throughout the week, when warranted, Larry will send out via charts or videos or both the key markets that he is watching during the day. This will be up-to-the-date active trading information that will help you in your daily trading. In Larry's first week alone, he sent out 25 charts, 6 videos, and a full report to his subscribers in just 1 week. If you're a technical trader that uses patterns and retracements to trade, then Larry's service Fibonacci 24/7 is something that you must try. Right now, new subscribers can get a full 30-day money-back guarantee. With nothing to risk, sign up now to Larry Pesavento's Fibonacci 24/7 by visiting the front page of TFNN.com under Trading Newsletters. Since 1984, Basil Chapman has been using the Chapman Wave methodology to advise traders of his expert market opinion. While originally hand-drawing charts from the late 1970s into the 1980s, Basil noticed that prices under most circumstances virtually always had a certain number of legs to the upside before declining sharply. Later, Basil found that computer software, which included the standard market technical indicators, enhanced the degree of accuracy in calling price turns as well as market trend calls. Thus was born the Chapman Wave sequence. Using the Chapman Wave methodology along with other indicators, Basil Chapman advises his subscribers of his expert market opinion each market day with his opening call newsletter. Right now, you can get a 2-week free trial to the opening call, Basil's daily trading newsletter, by visiting the front page of TFNN.com. Cancel at any time during that trial and pay absolutely nothing. Get your 2-week free trial to Basil's newsletter, The Opening Call, today by visiting TFNN.com. TFNN is excited about our new software charting program, The Art of Timing the Trade Charts. In collaboration with Tom O'Brien and using his best-selling book, The Art of Timing the Trade, Your Ultimate Trading Mastery System, David White has programmed an outstanding piece of software that will complement any trader's methodology. Using this first-of-its-kind program, The Art of Timing the Trade Charts allows you to scan thousands of stocks for Fibonacci formation setups, including Gartley's, ABC's, Butterflies, and much more. The Art of Timing the Trade Charts is designed to help you when scouring the markets for stocks just beginning to form the trading patterns that many investors spend days, weeks, or even months searching to find. And right now, we're offering licenses available at only $79 a month. We are so confident that you're going to love this new charting software that will even give you a 30-day unconditional money-back guarantee. Don't miss out on this incredible new piece of software. Get your copy of The Art of Timing the Trade Charts today by visiting TFNN.com.
Don't forget, you can listen to TFNN live on your mobile device 24 hours per day. Go to TFNN.com, then hit Watch Tiger TV. That's TFNN.com, then hit Watch Tiger TV for the latest market information.
Welcome back, folks. Well, the brave new world is here, folks. And, you know, we've always known that facial recognition, bottom line, biometric identification has been here for a while. I mean, when I signed the Bloomberg, I've been signing with my finger for a long period of time. Bottom line, Delta Airlines. Delta Airlines is going to be deploying facial recognition starting October 15th. Now, this is a test case. It's going to be done out of Atlanta. It is an opt-in type of system. But bottom line is that they are going to do facial. The way it works is on all their international flights, you prior to, just like, you know, when you make your reservations, what you're going to do prior to that is that you're going to get your passport. You're going to basically, there's going to be a way online that you're going to put your passport. Instead of when you go internationally right now, folks, you put your passport number in. There's going to be something on that page that you're going to scan your passport right there. Then what ends up happening is that passengers of Delta, Aeromexico, Air France, KLM, Virgin Airways that connect with them going out of Atlanta, bottom line, you're going to be, well, if that's what you do, they're claiming that it's actually going to replace not only the passport, but it's going to replace the ticket. And you're going to walk right on the plane. Right? If that's the case, you're going to walk up to a machine. You're going to look at the machine. They're going to say, yep, that's Tom O'Brien. Okay, start growling and prowling. And bottom line is that, so we'll see where this whole thing does shake out. But that's pretty intense, man. You know, we've watched plenty of movies with the biometric everything, and it looks to me like we are going to be there much quicker than I think many of us have thought we're going to be there. But that's how that baby is no doubt shaking out. Let's go over and take a look at the Gold Bugs Index. So the GDX, you know, up a bit today. You get the Gold Bugs Index flat. Bottom line is that what we did do out here yesterday inside that index, we did, let's see, 23 million shares. Yeah, it's a 23. So we're still going to need more share volume inside the XAU and the HUI. Stay right there, folks. Going to be coming back with some numbers after the close, including Micron.
You know what's cool? Taking something that's good for you. Something specifically formulated to help with weight loss, better sleep, stress reduction, and the need to detox.
Nico, our hunter and gatherer ancestors found all their nutritional requirements for health in their wild environment. But today, our food sources no longer contain the vitamins, minerals, and nutrients our bodies need to stay healthy and strong.
That's why we need Primal Edge Daily Nutrition. It includes a special blend of ionic, soil-based vitamins, minerals, fatty, and amino acids in an easy-to-use liquid form.
Primal Edge is powered by highly concentrated folic and humic acids, nature's preferred delivery system. They have been called miracle molecules because, like sunlight, air, and water, life cannot exist without them.
That's right, Paige. They ensure we receive all the nutrition we need to be healthy and thrive.
We take it every morning.
Primal Edge, formulated and approved by Nico and Paige of Living a Primal Lifestyle. Buy it today for just $89. Click on the Primal Edge banner on the front page of TFNN.com.
No matter what kind of trader you are, 2018.
The following is a presentation of TFNN.
The Tom O'Brien Show is produced every business day. Tom takes your phone calls toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044.
Oh, look who we have.
It's a beautiful day. Look at our man, Jim from Minneapolis. We gonna take it by storm?
Taking it by storm, baby.
I love that. That's a great saying, man. Hey, what's happening, brother?
Good morning, gentlemen. How you guys doing today?
Good, man. Yourself?
Oh, man. It's been the most incredible couple of days since when I called in on Friday, Litecoin busted out of that consolidation on the two-hour chart.
Okay.
And it just never looked back. It did a 100-point ABC up, and now it's very extended the way I look at it. But
yeah.
Holy tomorrow. I mean, it went up to $420 last night.
Now, Tom O'Brien.
Welcome, folks. This is Tom O'Brien of TFNN. We go 5 days a week. We go 10 hours a day. We go 24 hours a day on the internet at TFNN.com. Always remember, folks, whatever you think about, you bring about. Whatever you focus on grows. Hope everyone's having a great day, safe day. Let's make it a great night, folks. Yesterday's gone. Tomorrow's not here. What are you doing right now? Well, guess what? Market-wise, folks, let's take a look at it. We had the Dow and the S&P close at all-time highs. We had the Dow Industrials up 251 points, 26,656. S&P's up 22, trading 29.37. We go take a look at that volume. What you're going to see volume-wise out here in the NYSE, you're at 840. And the number you can see yesterday was 840 also. As that Dow started approaching its high, bottom line, you get the buyers get on board. They push that up into and over the all-time highs. Gold contract up $3.10, trading at 12.12 an ounce. Gold still needs price as well as volume. Volume-wise out here, what we did coming into a Friday, I like how we're coming into this Friday, that's the bottom line. We're gonna need a lot more volume though. We did 232,000 contracts today. We're at 12.12. That's saying that good old gold contract is going to go after the 12-18 price area once again, more than likely tomorrow. Bottom line, you're going to need like 300, 320 to basically have a shot of getting over it, because those sellers are just sitting right at that level, folks. And the last time that we were at, we did go up there, which was about a week ago. Bottom line, you had 302,000 contracts. That was on the 18th of September, and still couldn't hold price. That being said, though, bottom line, you didn't back off much. So I do expect we're going to get up and into that area again, particularly because if we do go over and look at the U.S. dollar, bottom line is that the dollar index went south today, had volume behind the move. You did 28,000 contracts. You were down 0.6 of one penny or 674 ticks. You did take out your swing low from June 28th, and you took it out, August 28th, and you did take it out with volume. So now that's going to set up. You're going after the 92,500. And what's going to get intriguing here is that, if we do take this and we put this on a continuous contract, what you're going to see is that when King Dollar came off its low April of this year, King Dollar was down at 88. King Dollar made the run up in order to get over the October 2017 swing highs. Now, that number was 95. It took about 8-9 weeks to get over it. We stayed over that level for 5 weeks. Now you're coming back inside that level with conviction. And what happens, folks, is that when you fail on price or volume and volume, or either one, and you come back inside the range with conviction, it's a big heads up. It's a heads up saying that the equity, or in this case, the dollar index, wants lower price. So I expect we're going to see some action out here, particularly because let's go over to the euro. What you're going to see inside the euro is that it's a direct correlation. Dollar bottom line goes down, euro goes up. Euro is right at the verge of, it just took out one swing point, which is 1.1733. Looks like it's going to go after the other one, and more than likely we could be at this other one tomorrow morning, which is the 1.1851. Now, that 1.1851 is the 14th of June. Now, you take that out, folks, and there's not much in between that and $1.23. And if that's what we get, you're going to see some action. We should see some action in the metals. Let's put it this way. Each and every time that this dollar has come down, thus far, we still haven't caught the bid inside the metal market. If we go over and we take a look at silver, silver's trading $14.35. We did 84,000 contracts out here today. You're still at the low end of the consolidation. What we did have out here is that you did get an expansion of volume. So we'll see whether it can actually catch a bid. Micron just came out with numbers. Let's go take a look at Micron. Micron closed at $46.06. That is trading right now at $47.12. So that's not catching a bid, kind of flat. Numbers like this go to Micron. Their net sales, the estimate was $8.25 billion. They did $8.44 billion. Earnings per share, $3.33 was the estimate. They did $3.53. So bottom line is that they beat the lower. They beat the bottom number, which is the earnings. They beat their top number, which is sales. Their gross margin is 61%. But there's something else in here, folks, because it still can't catch a bid. Pretty amazing, actually, because Micron Tech is down from $64 5 months ago. $64.66 right now. Bottom line, still trading at the $47 level. So not much action. The GDX, let's go see what they did coming into the close in the GDX. Volume-wise, that's good. Okay, so they've got volume in it again. They're at 44 million. They put volume into it. That's good. We're pushing into the swing high out here at $19.43, 48 cents. We had 52 million. Looks like this is going to go for it. I suspect we're going to go for it tomorrow morning. The XAU, what do we have in the XAU? XAU is flat out here today, $66.79. That looks like it wants to get up to the $69.58. The Gold Bugs Index, same type of setup. You had a flat market out here today. You're at 144. That looks like it wants to run into this 150.77 number. Some of the other higher volume equities out here and inside the, let's get that S&P up there. And the SPY tomorrow, folks, will have... A dividend paid, and then I believe that, we get Triple Witching tomorrow. We had Facebook is up $2.94. You had Microsoft up $1.87. Citigroup is up $1. The financials continued higher, folks. If we go take a look at the XLF, yesterday when the bond market broke that August low, XLF took off topside. Right now you're at $28.98. Still having a tough time going against the downdraft that was created out here in January. Bottom line is, though, guess what? The Dow Industrials made it through the downdraft that was out there in February. And in fact, if we go look at the Dow Industrials today, strength versus the weakness, what you had out here, there's only two Dow stocks that were in the red. That was Home Depot and Chevron. Home Depot was down 62 cents. Chevron was off 9. The big mover, well, it's intriguing because even Boeing, but it's not that Boeing was up a lot. Most of the movers were putting 10 to 12 positive points inside the S&P. Stay right there, folks. Come right back.
Folks, Tom O'Brien here. If you'd like to get my daily newsletter, Market Insights, then now is a great time to sign up for a 30-day free trial. Every morning by 9:30, I send out my morning letter to subscribers with market commentary on a variety of markets, currencies, and commodities to keep investors up to date on the day's trading action. Included in Market Insights are specific buy and sell recommendations for stocks, ETFs, and even options, with stops and price targets included for every trade in my newsletter. If you'd like to try my newsletter risk-free for 30 days, then head over to the front page of TFNN and you'll find Market Insights under Trading Newsletters. I use my years of trading experience to bisect and dissect the market every morning and give my subscribers the most important information they need to know for the day ahead. I even issue afternoon updates for my subscribers whenever warranted with important market action. I'm always scouring the market for the next great trading opportunity. Sign up for your 30-day free trial to my daily newsletter, Market Insights, today by visiting the front page of TFNN.com. Wow! Go get them, folks.
Has the current market volatility continued to stop you out of trades when the market spikes against you? Now is the perfect time to open up an account with Nadex. Nadex, the North American Derivatives Exchange, is a brand new, completely regulated Chicago-based exchange, and unlike most other exchanges, Nadex allows you to trade directly through them with direct market access when using their completely free trading platform, which also features real-time charts and full customization capability. One of the advantages of trading with Nadex in volatile markets is that your risk is always capped and you have the ability of keeping your trades open even when the market spikes against you. Nadex is completely brand new with a line of unique trading products that are unavailable anywhere else. See how it works at Nadex.com. That's Nadex.com. Or click on the Nadex banner on the front page of TFNN.com. Futures and options trading involves risk and may not be appropriate for all investors. Are China A shares hot or not? If you trade China A shares, now may be time to take a closer look. Trade CHAU or CHAD, Direction's daily CSI 300 China A-Share bull and bear ETFs. China A-Shares in either direction. Visit directioninvestments.com today. An investor should consider the investment objectives, risks, charges, and expenses of the Direction shares carefully before investing. The prospectus and summary prospectus contain this and other information about Direction shares. To obtain a prospectus or summary prospectus, please contact Direction shares at 866-476-7523. The prospectus or summary prospectus should be read carefully before investing. An investment in the funds is subject to risk, including the possible loss of principal. The funds are designed to be utilized only by sophisticated investors such as traders and active investors. Distributor Foreside Fund Services, LLC.
Call now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-873-7618.
Welcome back, folks. 877-927-6648. Let's get over and take a look at Tilray and see where that little baby shook out at the end of trading out here. So down at $37, trading $176. The spread out here for today Inside Tilray had a high of $244, a low of $158. Yeah, hit $158, okay, at $11.40 this morning. And bottom line is that you can expect that volatility to continue. If we go look at Canopy Growth Corporation, that was up $3, trading $52.40. This is looking to test its highs again. You get two high volume highs up here. One is 56.59. The other was yesterday at 55.64. That's Cronus, C-R-O-N. This was up $1.06. The low for the year is 170. The high is 15.30. This is quite a spike from yesterday, too. This is actually, I can make the case, this is going to get kind of weird with Cronus, because Cronus looks like it's an ABC up, actually. So 580 is your A. B is 1330, so we're dealing about $7.50. Your C is 926, so you got, 1675 or something. We'll see where that shakes out. Bottom line is that you get volatility out there in spades. And just something to keep in mind, folks, the ETF structure for these cannabis stocks is MJ. MJ is a, basically, there may be more than one of them, but MJ is a decent trading stock. What you will see out here is that they, what was interesting is, okay, so let me see. So exchange-traded fund incorporated in the U.S., the fund seeks total return performance from the Prime Alternative Harvest Index, which tracks companies likely to benefit from the increase in acceptance of various uses of the cannabis plant. So leverage, what I'm looking for is in here, I'm looking for the when and how they rebalance, because what you do have here is that, let me see, allocations, holdings, because they did read, they, oh, there it is, okay, I oh, interesting, okay, so the rebalance in frequency, folks, is semi-annually, so check this out, this is pretty cool, so that, this just did get rebalanced today, because yesterday when I brought this up, this was, Canopy Growth was actually number one, and Cronus was number two, and Tilray was number three. Now what you have is Tilray is the largest holding inside of this fund. It's 14.1% of the fund. Cronus is 10%. Canopy's 9.1%. You get Aurora for Cannabis at 8. GW Pharmaceutical is at 5.5. Let's go take a look at GW. So this equity here, the low for the year is 96. The high is 174. This is a new all-time high. So what kind of money this... Man, they take in nothing also. This is pretty amazing. So this company takes in $8 million a quarter, and it has a market cap of $4.7 billion. Well, better than Tilray, but bottom line is that a lot of these just seem like they're lofty. There's no doubt about that. GE, let's go take a look at GE. Now, GE came down today 40 cents. You're trading 12.46. This has been bouncing along the bottom here. What you did have, I think Morgan Stanley came out and put a $10 price point on it today, which put some pressure on the equity. And, you know, what GE does have is this high volume low that it's been going after from 2009. That the high of that low is 11.35. Now we came down to 11.94. You know, so I expect we're going to get down there. The real question is that will it be the high of that low that saves it? And it very well could be, because it's big numbers here. It's 5.9 billion shares on the monthly basis. That's what was traded at that low. You know, and that low, of course, came off of GE had been trading at $42 in 2007, gets all the way down to that level. And what GE has fundamentally, they still have legacy issues in a huge way, because when GE's been selling these companies off, they basically have been on the hook for any losses in a few of those companies going forward. And that's what that's why that the stock is still problems. We go take a look at Bitcoin. So first you had the Bitcoin craze. Now we get the Reefer Madness craze. And when I was just talking with my man, Mr. Jason Path, who kicks us off every trading day right here at 8:30, what was intriguing is that he was saying that this was the same year, I mean, as to when that you saw the Bitcoin start taking off topside. Yeah, look at this. Okay, this gets interesting, right? So if I bring this back, what you're going to see, unreal. In September, yeah, this is pretty wild. So September of last year, you know, Bitcoin had basically, you know, if we go back March of 2017, Bitcoin's at $900. I fast forward to September of 2017, your Bitcoin is at the 2,900. Now, this is how it happened, though. We went from $2,900 the week of September 15th, and by December, you're at 10,000. Unbelievable. So we went from 3,000 to 10,000 in 3 months. And, you know, we'll see if, in fact, the cannabis stocks are going to end up doing the same thing. There's no doubt that what we're going to see out here now, you're at all-time highs. You get a melt-up scenario going on. You get the end of the year coming in. Money's flush. Greed's out there. You know, we'll see where they can push these equities. There's no doubt that Tilray was one of the first equities that we've seen that act absolutely psycho. It seems that that's been one of the first parts since the 2000, year 2000, you know. And, of course, that, you know, turned into a problem. The differential there, I would say, is that you had a whole slew of the internet stocks, and that's how they acted. Amazon, bottom line, come out with new, more features today. And this is what's going to be intriguing with Amazon is this, is that the Echo, and they're going to use the Echo, folks, and they're going to use that Echo for bottom line powering all of our homes. I guess the big deal here is, like, how do you get over the privacy concerns when you get your house wired on the internet through the Echo into a cloud? It's a tough one to call, man. It really is. Stay right there, folks. Come right back.
Hi, folks, this is Tom O'Brien. If you'd like to be the bank and get the type of interest they receive instead of the low interest rates they give to clients, then I have an investment you may want to take a look at. I'm offering 4-year secured first mortgages on buildable city lots in St. Petersburg, Florida. The investment can be anywhere from $30,000 to $75,000 per buildable city lot. The interest paid is 7% per year, paid monthly. Depending on the investment, the income per month per lot ranged from $175 for a $30,000 investment to $437.50 for a $75,000 investment. If you are in the CD market, you want to look at this investment. St. Petersburg is located in Pinellas County, which is the densest county in Florida. If you're looking for an investment with your principal intact that pays a good interest rate, this may be for you. The supply is limited, so act now. For more information on these secured first mortgage opportunities, you can call me at 877-518-9190. That's 877-518-9190.
No matter what kind of trader you are, 2018 is a great time to try out a subscription to Tom O'Brien's Gold Report.
Whether you just plan on diversifying your portfolio with some exposure to gold and gold mining equities, or you're a gold bull that sees 2018 as the year of commodities, now is a great time to sign up for the Gold Report. Tom O'Brien publishes his Gold Report every Monday morning before the market opens and covers a variety of topics, including gold, silver, platinum, copper, the XAU and HUI, the dollar, bonds, South African rand, as well as more than 20 of the most actively traded mining equities. Start your 2018 off with a bang and sign up for the Gold Report today. The Gold Report is a long-term newsletter where the focus is on building real wealth through the management of a successful portfolio of gold stocks. For all the details and to start your subscription right now, visit the front page of TFNN.com and you'll find the Gold Report under Investment Newsletters. The Path of Least Resistance, David White's daily market letter, gives you trade recommendations based on David's proprietary power law vector indicator that put the odds of success overwhelmingly in your favor. He'll give you the entry price, price target, and stop price for each stock and option trade. David combines his years of trading experience along with his background in technology and computing to offer his subscribers his take on the markets on a daily basis. Every trading day by 9:30, David publishes his morning issue of The Path of Least Resistance, along with updates sent out throughout the week whenever there is new actionable trading information. All new subscribers receive a 30-day, no-questions-asked, money-back guarantee. To sign up for David White's daily trading newsletter right now, visit the front page of TFNN.com and you'll find The Path of Least Resistance under Trading Newsletters.
This segment is brought to you by Think or Swim. For more information, just click the Think or Swim banner on the front page of TFNN.com.
Welcome back, folks. Let's go over to the oil market. So crude oil out here today, down 0.9%, 65 cents. We got up into the $71.35. And the last time we were up here, you got the 70.98. Your high in this consolidation is 71.10. And so what you can see is that you basically reached the high, couldn't handle the high, come off the high. That's the end, bottom line. Now we're going to go after the lower end of this consolidation. The lower end of the consolidation is laying out here at 63 to 64. If we go and take a look at the XLE, you're going to see that the XLE also couldn't hold price out here today. You're up 2 pennies. You were up, you know, at $75.71. You're at 75.12. Bottom line, your swing point that it can't handle is $75.54. You know, we got to the 71, got over it, couldn't handle it. This is, let's go to, it's probably Chevron again. Chevron's been given that a tough time. Yeah, Chevron got to 121.32, closed at 119.42. Just can't catch a bid. ExxonMobil was going after the swing points, the high. Okay, got it. Exxon was up 19 cents, $84.82. That being said, that's not going to be enough to get any juice going inside the XLE, because Exxon is coming into a vicious downdraft that was created out there in February. That's when Exxon went from $89 down into the $73 in only two weeks. Okay, so that was one monster number on the way down, no doubt about that. J.P. Morgan, the banks, different animal than the banks. And this is what's going to be, it's all about that spread. J.P. Morgan, let's bring them back for a second, see if they might be the first ones to try to overtake this high of 119.33, because we're at 118.63. Looks like it wants to go for it. We go to take a look at Bank of America, BAC. Well, actually, let's look at Berkshire, BRK, because Berkshire is the largest weighting structure inside. Yeah, you're 221.68. And this just overtook its highs. Yeah, 217.62 is the all-time high, I believe. Yeah, you just overtook it. You know, so this is going to... September 20th right now. Yeah, bottom line is that you overtook it. You know, and if we bring this back, you're going to see Berkshire. 2009 was a $45 stock. You're at 221. Revenue, I've never looked at revenue. I'm curious about what this is. Oh, look at that revenue. Oh, my God. So, $246 billion with a B. Big numbers. And growth-wise, it looks like their insurance group is still growing. It's insurance is growing by 4% a year. Yep, that's how that's shaken out. And that's and worldwide, they're growing by 2.5% a year. So bottom line, for a monster company, they definitely are still growing. Let's go take a look at the small caps out here, the IWM. So IWM is 16 million shares. You're coming into 20. You're 171.22. What I expect you're going to see out here tomorrow, folks, is this. So picture, we got triple witching out here tomorrow. That's bottom line is going to, you know, no doubt put some volatility inside the marketplace. And particularly, it's going to put volatility at the open. So be prepared at the open, folks, for a decent heavy volatility market. If we go over and we take a look at the, let's go take a look at the yen, because what we did have inside the U.S. dollar today, U.S. dollar goes south, euro goes north, pound goes north. Now, for the metal market, folks, what we need to happen, it doesn't look to me like it's going to happen tonight, is the yen to go south. Right now, the yen is going north, meaning it's getting weaker. It's 112 yen to one U.S. dollar, and we want to see it down into 110, 105, all of the above. If we go take a look at the Nikkei, you know, when the yen got weaker, Nikkei went topside, broke the consolidation that had been in place since May of this year. And last night, you know, had a flat market last night, but there's no doubt the two prior nights, it launched itself. We went from a price point of 23,029 to 23,674. If we do take this back just a bit, yeah, it's going into its February downdraft. So just real possible the Nikkei also wants to go hit an all-time high, and that's going to be 24,129. What would be, what is easier, this is what ends up happening here too, is that when you see the aspect of their currency getting weaker, well, it's an easier, basically, way to get up and to get into those highs. Why? Because bottom line is that when you actually have weaker currencies, your number gets bigger, but guess what? It doesn't mean you have more buying power. That's what it's all about, you know? So that's where this gets a little bit tricky in the aspect of where these are going. Let's go take a look at a couple of the royalty stocks inside the gold market. We had Royal Gold today flat. We are at 78.34. Franco-Nevada up 38 cents. Both of them aren't saying much as to where the physical gold is going. Rangel Resources, which used to be one of the strongest stocks out here, that got a little traction into it. We'll see where they can get more. Get $1.15. We're going to need a lot more than that. We're off a low of 59. You're at 64.59. You are going to need more volume. Tesla. Let's go see what we're happening with Tesla out here. Tesla flat market today, 298. And the roll on Tesla, folks, has been a slow rollover. You know, if we take a look at Tesla, Tesla's made its high at $386. That was back in June of 2017. So bottom line is that you're talking about 15 months ago. What Tesla does have is that he has these high volume lows that are sticking out. And I do expect you're going to go after those high volume lows. And what that's going to be all about, of course, well, it could be very well about production also. But I suspect in between that, it's going to be about the SEC. And we'll see whether it's going to be about the Department of Justice also. The SEC is already basically been all over them. The Department of Justice, well, what we don't know what they're looking for or saying, but I suspect it's going to be all about that tweet that, number one, we're going to be going private at 420. And that wasn't the big deal. The big deal, I said, inside the context of fraud, which that's what they'd be looking at, is saying that you actually had the financing set up. That's where this gets really dicey, because so picture something. Picture that you never owned Tesla. You could own it or not own it, it doesn't matter. But if you have a stock that's trading, let's say at 350, the CEO's coming out saying, we're gonna go private at 420 and I have financing. It's like, hey, why don't I buy it at 350? He's gonna give me 420 for it. That's where the problems lie, inside Tesla. Stay right there, folks, come right back.
Many of our new listeners have heard about The Tiger's Den. The Tiger's Den is a lively community where professional traders and investors can meet, exchange ideas and information in a comfortable, moderated atmosphere. Hear all of the TFNN shows, plus see all of the charts as they happen live and have access to archives of all of those charts. You can test drive The Tiger's Den absolutely free for 30 days and greatly enrich your knowledge of these markets and how to make your money work for you. Details on The Tiger's Den are on the front page of TFNN.com.
Monday, September 24th, TFNN is launching a new updated version of our website. You can still visit us at the same TFNN.com URL, and starting Monday, you'll be able to experience the new and improved TFNN website. If you're a current subscriber, don't worry, your subscription will be automatically transferred. The new TFNN.com will allow much easier access to all your account and subscription information. Get ready for the new TFNN.com, educating investors.
Since 1984, Basil Chapman has been using the Chapman Wave methodology to advise traders of his expert market opinion. While originally hand-drawing charts from the late 1970s into the 1980s, Basil noticed that prices under most circumstances virtually always had a certain number of legs to the upside before declining sharply. Later, Basil found that computer software, which included the standard market technical indicators, enhanced the degree of accuracy in calling price turns as well as market trend calls. Thus was born the Chapman Wave sequence. Using the Chapman Wave methodology along with other indicators, Basil Chapman advises his subscribers of his expert market opinion each market day with his opening call newsletter. Right now, you can get a two-week free trial to the opening call, Basil's daily trading newsletter, by visiting the front page of TFNN.com. Cancel at any time during that trial and pay absolutely nothing. Get your two-week free trial to Basil's newsletter, The Opening Call, today by visiting TFNN.com.
I'm certain you are or strive to be one of the best at everything you do in life. It's the most common trait that we tigers and tigresses share. If you're looking to become the best of the best when it comes to managing your money, let me teach you to do what most wealth managers tell you can't be done, which is how to time the markets. I'm Steve Rhodes, author of Mastering Probability, and for the last 12 months, Timer Digest has been tracking my newsletter signals, which have earned me the ranking as their number one market timer in the nation for the S&P 500 for the last 12, 6, and 3 months. Timer Digest also ranks me as the number one market timer for gold as well. The fact is, markets can be timed, and I'll teach you the exact set of tools that I use that has transformed me into one of the best at what I do. Sign up for Mastering Probability today by clicking on the newsletter tab on the homepage of TFNN.com and get immediate access to workshops where I take you step by step how to use an extraordinary set of tools as well as provide great market calls too. Sign up today.
Call now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-873-7618.
Tom O'Brien.
Welcome back, folks. Let's go take a look at Twitter, TWTR. So Twitter out here trading at a price point of $29.85. The low for the year is $16.57. The high is at $47.79. And next time they come out with numbers is going to be on the 25th of October. Kind of laying its lows. Doesn't look like it wants to get off those lows either. Facebook is the same type of setup. Facebook down off its high of 218. We're at 166, which is unusual in that we have Google right behind them. Google, it was up $15.50 today, but bottom line is that that is off its high of 1273. And right now you're at 1186. Amazon, different ball game. We go take a look at the Microsoft. Microsoft came back in spades out here today. Qualcomm's been in the news quite a bit. If we take a look at Qualcomm, Qualcomm, low for the year is 48, high 76. You're laying right next to it right now. We're at 74.60. And yeah, bottom line is that that also wants to stay at those highs. Apple is a different animal here. Now, what's intriguing is that, you know, Apple, bottom line, you know, you're coming up to Apple's most successful quarter. So here, watch this. Well, so Apple's trading 220. Your high is 225. If we take a look at the revenue, you'll see it gets pretty dramatic when we take a look at the aspect of it would be October, November, December. So it's not quite right now. It's going to be October, November, December, of course, because then the holiday quarter goes in. And check out the number, how this goes. They expect to do $61 billion this quarter and then jump to $92 billion the following quarter. So they're looking for big numbers as they do each and every season. And if you want to see the last 5 years, it's pretty amazing that Apple, cash-wise, has grown from $182 billion in gross revenue in 2014 to $264 billion this year. And they're looking to do $279 next year. So right now, it looks like in America, they're growing by about 2%. In Asia, they're growing almost 4%. In Europe, they're growing by 2%. Japan, they're growing about 1.75%. Inside, when you do break down these numbers, so the iPhone, out of the $264 billion, $141 is iPhone. Macintosh is $25 billion. iPad is $19 billion. iPad is contracting by 4.5% per year. And then you got other services at $12.9 billion. What's going to get intriguing inside the tech space is that what type of growth is going to come in Amazon and the related businesses that they're actually into, meaning that their web service is their largest growth aspect right now. Their web services are growing by 17%. No, it's more than that. I think it's 49%. It's an outrageous number. Their web service is growing. What is intriguing, of course, is that what Amazon did lay out yesterday is that they laid out the aspect of that they're going to open up 3,000 Amazon to-go stores. We'll see how that shakes out. That's going to be going against the 7-Elevens of the world and the convenience stores of the world. The home aspect, the home security systems out here today, pretty intense, you know, because what Amazon's looking to do, so what they unveiled today was this. They are looking for a gadget to be put in every one of our, not just homes, folks, in everyone, our rooms in our homes, right from a microwave oven to a wall clock. Bottom line is that, let's see where they're coming. They say that they also upgraded the speakers inside their Dot, okay? They're looking to basically, they claim that they just got 70% better sound, and they're going after basically Sonos' turf. That's what it looks like anyway. Let's see, what else they're going to have? They're going to have, of course, they're going to have, so Alexa is going to be, which is, the Dot, the whole ball of wax. You're going to be able to talk to Alexa, telling Alexa to put on your microwave oven, tell her what time the cook times are. You're going to be able to say, check this out, defrost peas, cook a baked potato. Then they're going to have Alexa Guard, Alexa God is the home security product. That has to do, that is, it's, it only has, it also has to do with the aspect of if someone's coming through your windows, but this is pretty cool. It works also as a carbon dioxide in a smoke. All of these, of course, send alerts right to your phone. And then, so check this out. This is all brought out today. So then what is also going to happen is that, let's say you have your car in the garage. Okay, so what are they going to do here? Let's see. Alexa's accessing car. You're going to, well, of course, you're going to access your car speakers through your Bluetooth. Sorry about that, folks. Okay. Bottom line is that it looks to me like they are going to be basically trying to get inside this in a huge way. And there's no doubt that I'm not quite sure that I, you know, you hear the stories about Alexa. It's a two-way device, you know. So it's like you want a two-way device in all your rooms. I'm not sure. The convenience is a big deal. There's no doubt about that. The convenience is a big deal. Right now, I've been putting these Vivid systems in, and they're good, and they are also a two-way deal, and you can pick them up right on your phone. Bottom line is that you can talk out, they can talk in. Real question is that what else can everyone get off of that, you know, at the same time? Let's go over and we take a look at the good old Walmart. We start talking, of course, Amazon, well, Walmart, bottom line, up 51 cents today. You're trading $95. This is off the high of 109. And as we get closer to the holidays here, folks, we'll see who is going to basically win this battle. What is strange is that UPS, you know, as well as FedEx, bottom line, they're not at all-time highs. Now, UPS... We're at 119, its all-time high is 135. FedEx, your all-time high is 274, you're at 246. And that kind of says that Amazon evidently is using a lot of their own delivery mechanisms, or they're subbing out to someone other than them, because we know that their volume of shipments are going up dramatically. And I guess maybe if the post office was public, we'd see it right there. Stay right there, folks. Come right back.
Larry Pesavento has just started his brand new service, Fibonacci 24/7, and he's already delivering content to his subscribers on a daily basis when the market's opened and even on weekends. Each Monday, you'll receive Larry's written report that provides detailed commentary and a summary on the charts and videos that Larry sends out. And throughout the week, when warranted, Larry will send out via charts or videos or both the key markets that he is watching during the day. This will be up-to-the-date active trading information that will help you in your daily trading. In Larry's first week alone, he sent out 25 charts, 6 videos, and a full report to his subscribers in just 1 week. If you're a technical trader that uses patterns and retracements to trade, then Larry's service Fibonacci 24/7 is something that you must try. Right now, new subscribers can get a full 30-day money-back guarantee. With nothing to risk, sign up now to Larry Pesavento's Fibonacci 24/7 by visiting the front page of TFNN.com under Trading Newsletters. David White's newsletter, The Technology Insider, is focused like a laser on finding the next big things in technology. If you had invested only $10,000 in Microsoft in 1986, you'd have been a millionaire by 2000. Disruptive technology like Microsoft's is the key to these massive long-term profits, and The Tech Insider is the vehicle from TFNN to capitalize on these opportunities. This is the go-to newsletter that identifies, monitors, and profits on mostly little-known cutting-edge companies with great long-term prospects. David's experience is as an inventor of Emmy-winning animation products for TV and Hollywood that propelled a company public. Match that with 14 years as a full-time trader, and he's uniquely qualified to guide you through the light-speed world of ever-evolving high-tech. If you're ready to ride the next big technology bull market for less than $40 per month, log on to TFNN.com and get your 2-week free trial to the Technology Insider. Get in on the ground floor of the next big thing today.
With over $56 million in cash and over $66 million in working capital, Great Panther Silver is positioned as a company with a solid foundation and poised for growth. While completely unhedged to the price of silver, Great Panther retains 100% ownership in two producing mines in Mexico, which is the top silver-producing country in the world, along with future potential production in Peru. Great Panther is highly leveraged to the price of silver, and after a great year of performance in 2016, Great Panther Silver has a strong outlook for 2017 as well. With good liquidity in trading and strong fundamentals on the balance sheet, while remaining completely unhedged to the price of gold and silver, now is a perfect time to take a closer look at this equity. If you'd like to find out more about Great Panther Silver, then go to greatpanther.com or check them out on the NYSE market, symbol GPL, or the TSX, symbol GPR.
Don't forget, you can listen to TFNN live on your mobile device 24 hours per day. Go to TFNN.com, then hit Watch Tiger TV. That's TFNN.com, then hit Watch Tiger TV for the latest market information.
Welcome back, folks. After the close, Adobe, which has a low for the year of 143, a high of 277, they take revenue in of $9 billion. They are going to be buying Marketo. That's $4.75 billion. This is, I don't believe this is a public company. Let me just look at this for a second. M-A-R-K-E-T-O. Oh, good, it is. Okay, 1 second. Oh, no, it's not. That. This is funny. It used to be a public company. Then they took it private, Vista Equity Partners. Okay, so bottom line is that they're pushing this baby back out again. Adobe, no doubt, has been on a run. And, when we take a look at it, let's see. Yeah. Now, that's a large acquisition because, you know, Adobe takes in $9 billion. Bottom line is that they're spending $4.75 for this company. But Adobe prints some big money, man. I mean, big money. They bring $6.82 to the bottom line this year. So that, no doubt, is a big number. What's to look far out here tonight, folks? You can expect more volatility inside the dollar index. Bottom line, though, it looks like the market liked a strong dollar, the market likes a weak dollar. You know, fundamentally, you can see why the Dow Industrials go higher, because what you do have is that when the dollar is lower, the big Dow stocks, which are the large multinationals, can sell a lot more because people can afford it. What I expect we're going to see here is that this euro is going to continue higher. Euro looks like it wants to basically bust out of the zone. And if it does, it's going to be a big deal because this consolidation has been in place since May of this year. Always remember, folks, whatever you think about, you bring about. Whatever you focus on grows. And whatever you want in life, folks, visualize it like a nice big motion picture. Step into it, take ownership, and fly with it. Everything you need is right inside you. Have a blast with it. Look forward to speaking right back here, 8:30 tomorrow morning. Join our man, Jason Paff, morning market kickoff. Wow! Go get him, folks.
TFNN is excited about our new software charting program, The Art of Timing the Trade Charts. In collaboration with Tom O'Brien and using his best-selling book, The Art of Timing the Trade, Your Ultimate Trading Mastery System, David White has programmed an outstanding piece of software that will complement any trader's methodology. Using this first-of-its-kind program, The Art of Timing the Trade Charts allows you to scan thousands of stocks for Fibonacci formation setups, including Gartley's, ABC's, Butterflies, and much more. The Art of Timing the Trade Charts is designed to help you when scouring the markets for stocks just beginning to form the trading patterns that many investors spend days, weeks, or even months searching to find. And right now, we're offering licenses available at only $79 a month. We are so confident that you're going to love this new charting software that will even give you a 30-day unconditional money-back guarantee. Don't miss out on this incredible new piece of software. Get your copy of The Art of Timing the Trade Charts today by visiting TFNN.com.